how to deal with such unwelcome visitors. At this time of year, the earth warms slowly, and lift from hot air is harder to find. Long flights are tiring. Hunting from perches has to suffice. The pole trap bit, but didn't kill at once. Seized by the leg, his long struggle for freedom was wasted. Life drained little by little from the hanging bird. Mordicus comes here every day to warm his feathers in the morning sun. The dead buzzard was young too, an intruder searching for a niche, his own place. Mordicus flies long and hard, beating his way steadily across new territories, over unexplored places. He comes to rest at last in a marshy spot and waits for food to show itself. The frogs are safe enough, so long as they don't move. He flies on, mile after mile. Every day he has to adapt to new places, new situations. He has no instinct yet to settle in a territory of his own. He feeds where he can, and he's always alone. He will live this way for many months, shunned by all creatures, even his own kind. He will endure 2 years of solitude, 2 bitter Exmoor winters. In the spring of his third year, Mordicus is fully mature. The weaker creatures that die in the cold make food for the survivors. A large female buzzard tears greedily at a carcass.